Nope.
My turn.
I can do this. Here I go!
Overdrive!
Now!
An opening! Leave this to me! Hey! Now's our chance!
It's my turn! Here's our chance! Laura, please help me!
Understood!
Understood. Yeah.
Everyone. Well, I won't deny that was an entertaining diversion. But you'd do well to intensify your training regimen if you hope to best me.
How is he so strong?
We didn't stand a chance.
He might even be stronger than Sarah.
Are you guys okay?
Hey, you really think you've got time to be worrying about them? You ain't getting out of this one, Green.
All right, bring it on! It's time to settle this, Crow! Bring it on!
This'll be a tough one. Be careful!
settled enough for you?
You didn't even bother to use that trump card of yours.
He wasn't even trying last time, then, was he?
Come on. With the way you are now, I don't even need to try. I'll always win. And that, Reen, perfectly illustrates just how massive the gulf between us is. Maybe you think you've had it tough up till now, but you're gonna need to go through a hell of a lot more if you want to even the odds.
I see the battle here has come to an end.
Hey, Vita.
I can't help but feel a little bummed that everything went exactly as I thought it would. Still, it just goes to show how much faith I have in your skills, my sweet Azure Chevalier.
Funny, I don't recall ever becoming yours. How's everything up top?
I think it's only a matter of time before the battle is decided. But we've caused enough trouble for the people of Ymir already. It's about time we brought this to a close. Fenestrum Phantasma Window.
My apologies for not coming down to speak with you in person, ladies and gentlemen of Thor's Military Academy. You know who I am, of course, but I am Duke Kyand, ruler of the Lemaire province and supreme leader of the Noble Alliance.
Duke Kyand?
So even the big guy himself is here.
I must say, what a curious group we have here. I heard as much, but allow me to extend my most heartfelt congratulations. My expectations have thoroughly been exceeded. When I saw young Eustace and Laura in Legram earlier this year, I could never have imagined this is how we would next meet. Oh, I'm sure your parents must have warned you against wandering off with such disreputable individuals on a number of occasions. But I suppose every child thinks that they alone know what is best for themselves. Duke Albarea was simply livid about what happened. But it can't hurt to learn more about the outside world,
Every word that leaves his mouth is condescending.
Did you come all the way here just to tell us that?
Don't be silly, child. Reen Schwarzer. I had this meeting arranged because I wanted to speak with you. Perhaps the method was a touch too garish for something so simple, but do forgive me for not formally requesting an audience.
With me?
With you. Allow me to get right to the point. I wish to invite you, Ashen Chevalier, aboard our flagship.
Huh? Wait, why?
I've heard all about your magnificent exploits across the land, and so I thought it would be nice to sit down and have a long, pleasant chat with you. About the past, the present, as well as your future.
Are you suggesting...
You want Reen to join the Noble Alliance?
Should you accept my invitation, we will withdraw peacefully from Ymir. Furthermore, I give you my personal assurance that we will leave this village alone for the duration of this war. A fine proposition, is it not? Are we interested?
Very well. Allow me to accept your invitation.
Don't be an idiot! This is clearly a trap! They wouldn't come all the way out here and take you into their flagship if it weren't.
I appreciate your concern. A trap or not, this might be a good chance for us, too. I think I'd regret it if I let it pass. Balamar, transport Selene back outside.
Are you certain?
Now hold it right there!
Don't worry about me. The odds were against all of us getting back together, but we did it. And I'm sure we can do it again, too. So just wait with Emma for now. I'll be back before you know it. Balamar, if you would?
Very well.
But wait!
It seems the time has come for us to part ways once again.
But remember this. You're an Albarea. There is power and dignity in that name, to whatever end you would use it. I want you to prove that the convictions you cling to are worthy of your loyalty. Not for my benefit, but for yours.
Wait!
Well met, Lord Schwarzer. It's a pleasure to see you again. Allow me to extend my apologies for the harm my father visited upon this town and its people. We're simply going to borrow young Reen for a short while. There's nothing to worry about. I'm a busy man these days, though, so for now, I bid you adieu.
Reen! Reen!
We all finally got back together, too. Why?
Sorry, but I'll be back, I promise. So stay safe!
Master Reen! Reen!
Reen Schwarzer, truth be told, we don't want this war to drag on any more than you do.
Really?
We only acted as we did due in part to our dearly departed Chancellor's behavior being far too unreasonable to justify turning a blind eye. He garnered the trust of His Majesty, and in turn misused that trust. He flagrantly disregarded this nation's beloved culture and traditions. Surely you too noticed this.
Well...
But as I said, the cause of our nation's ills is now gone. Now, all that remains is to turn back the hands of time just a touch, and the good old days of the Empire will be upon us once more. The key to this bright future lies in putting aside our differences and joining hands. Am I wrong?
I'm afraid that yes, you are. Do you honestly believe that people can so easily put aside their differences after all the Alliance has done? You occupied Heimdall and effectively took every one of its citizens hostage, imprisoned the Imperial family. And let's not forget how you're now in league with the enemy nation responsible for the destruction of Gorellia Fortress. After all that, the Imperial army would never bow their heads to the likes of you, even if the rest of the population did.
My word, I'm afraid there's been a terrible misunderstanding. The Imperial family is simply under our loving protection. They certainly haven't been in prison. But that does bring me to exactly why I want you to help us. The Azure Knight is already on our side. But if we had your Ashen Knight as well, that would mean we'd have two of the great knights of Erebonian legend to put into play. Couple them with our Panzer Soldats, and the Imperial Army's armored divisions would cower before us. You may not find us winning the war ideal, but this union benefits everyone more than carrying on until our inevitable victory,
I don't think it's that simple.
I beg to differ. The presence of Soldats units on a battlefield makes a tremendous difference. What they may lack in firepower and armor compared to tanks, they make up for in mobility and versatility. But more important than even those factors is the psychological impact they have on our opponents.
Well...
we're only human. As such, we are as captivated as we are terrified of giant beings bearing human form. And if that holds true even for mass-produced Soldats made with modern technology, it will be all the more true for the divine knights of legend you and Crow possess.
Can't argue with that logic.
I will say it once more. Gilliath Osborne is dead. And with his death, all that's left to be done is end this ridiculous war and return. Only then will everything be as it should. That includes both your pleasant academy life and the peaceful days of darling Elise and her friend the princess.
Are you trying to...
whatever you ultimately decide, their safety is guaranteed. I would ask that you promise him this, if nothing else, Your Grace.
But of course, I'm not a monster.
Rufus.
We may stand on opposite sides of this conflict, but I still sit on Thor's board of directors. And in that capacity, I suggest you consider carefully the choice before you. After all, every soldier must decide for himself whether a cause is worth fighting. Perhaps even dying for. I look forward to hearing your answer.
All that's left to be done is end this ridiculous war, and only then will everything be as it should. That includes both your pleasant academy life and the peaceful days.
I suggest you consider carefully the choice before you. After all, every soldier must decide for himself whether a cause is worth fighting, perhaps even dying for. I look forward to hearing your answer.
Keep racking your brain like that and smoke will start coming out of your ears. Hey now, no need to give me that look. I figured I was gonna find you busy thinking everything over like your life depended on it. And what do you know? I was right. It's tough being popular. If you joined us, I could get away with doing half the work I am now. So come on, stop freaking out about it so much and make a choice. Grub, of course. Kinda early, but I brought you your lunch. Mind if I join you? Oh, that kind of food more your thing? Okay then, give me a minute while I go ask the chef to whip something up. Cool. All right, dig in. Yeah, they're called fish burgers. Pretty good, right? Well, glad to hear. Guess it was worth putting my cooking skills to the test after all. Was my first time cooking in a while, too. Sharon could probably do better, though. But I wanted to give it a shot anyway. This stuff was like soul food back in Jirai where I grew up.
To think, all the time we spent searching for the leader of the Imperial Liberation Front, and he was right under our noses. Crow Armbrust, from the Jirai SEZ.
Oh, yeah. Vita was using some weird thing of hers to let you see what was going on, wasn't she? So I guess you saw what happened there. Yeah, by pure coincidence. It's changed a lot since I was last there, so it was kind of surreal being back again. But it was nostalgic in its own way, too. Where's the fun in prying into a guy's past? Save all that talk for your number one in class. Who's the lucky girl anyway? Elisa? Laura? Emma? Fee? And don't tell me it's Millium, because, you know, it... You're really serious. My past really isn't that big of a deal, you know. It's got nothing on yours, that's for sure. If you find yourself thinking that's all when I'm done, well, I warned you. So, you really want to know? All right, you win. Like I said, it's just your run-of-the-mill sob story. Pick up any history textbook and you'll probably find a dozen others just like it. It's the kind of story that's so common no one bothers to remember it, like it never even happened. Back in those days, Jirai was known as Jirai City. It was a city-state off the coast of northwest Zemuria that prospered through maritime trade with West Erebonia, Northambria, and Remiferia. It had a population of around 150,000 people, so it wasn't exactly a big place or anything. Because of that, the surrounding nations left it alone and let us live out our days in peace. We were pretty fortunate, all things considered, until about 20 years ago. That was when the Northumbrian disaster struck, and much of the Principality of Northumbria was turned to salt. And as a result, trade on the northwest shore was reduced to virtually nothing. Day after day, Jirai's prosperity started to fade away. Still, it wasn't all bad. We had our fishing, our historic landmarks, our septium mines. We could make use of those to get trade going again, both to keep our state running and to help out Northumbria. In fact, the one who advocated that approach was the mayor, my grandfather. He was the last mayor Jirai City ever had. He was a stubborn old bastard, but he had this wry sense of humor. I lost my mom and dad early. He taught me just about everything a guy could know. He was like a mom, dad, and your old master rolled into one, I guess. Anyway, fast forward to 10 years ago. Out of nowhere, we received this proposal from the Erebonian government. They said they wanted to extend a railway line from Heimdall all the way to Jirai. We relied on the sea for trade before, but there wasn't any reason to believe we couldn't benefit from being connected to Heimdall by rail. The proposal drew overwhelming support from the city's council, and as a result, my grandfather was forced to accept. Within a year, the city had all of its old life back and then some. The streets were more bustling than ever. But keep in mind, this was the result of huge amounts of imperial capital flowing into the city. Land and buildings we once treasured were bought up left and right. Everything became a target for investment. People only cared about making money. Something similar supposedly happened in Crossbell too, but unlike there, no opposition existed in Jirai. My grandfather sensed something was off, and he tried what he could to get the situation under control. Then one day, someone blew up the railway line leading to Jirai. Everyone demanded that it be repaired as quickly as possible. Everyone except the imperial government. Instead, they panned our national security arrangements for being insufficient and threatened to withdraw all imperial capital. The city was left in an uproar like we'd never seen. Shares plummeted, and with no one able to ascertain the culprit's identity, chaos reigned. That was when he showed up. Chancellor Gilliath Osborne, in his third year as representative of the imperial government, personally came to Jirai. We then received a second proposal.
The restoration of the railway and its future security will be seen to by the Imperial Army. In return for our continued assistance and safekeeping, Jirai will come under the wing of our glorious empire and attain even greater prosperity as a special economic zone.
The timing was too good to be true, really. Realizing this, my grandfather staunchly opposed the idea. He tried everything he could to convince the city's council to reject the offer. Unfortunately, once you taste the sweet fruit of prosperity, it's hard to want to go back. The council, made up of influential merchants and all their greed, jumped at the offer. And tempted by the elimination of customs, together with the tax breaks from being an SEZ, many of the citizens did too. And during all that, they'd conveniently found a suspect behind the railway incident, my grandfather. He loved Jirai more than anyone, and up till then, its people loved him too. And yet, virtually overnight, he found himself facing the wrath of both the city's council and the citizens alike. Left with no choice, he resigned from his position as mayor, and Jirai formally became part of the empire. Both of these things happened on the same exact day. That was 8 years ago. Naturally, everyone knew my grandfather wasn't the one who did it. They knew who was really responsible. They just turned a blind eye to the truth. See? I warned you. Just your run-of-the-mill sob story. One day, he just up and died. Once he resigned, the whole affair with the railway getting blown up was all but forgotten. He lived comfortably in retirement for about half a year, fell ill, and that was that. He just lost the will to go on, I guess. Like I said, he was the only family I had. I mean, I had plenty of friends even then, but I chose to leave it all behind. I was 13 at the time. I wandered the land, doing whatever I had to get by. That was when I met old Kyan, who happily indulged my hatred for the Chancellor. And with his financial backing, I went out with the goal to find others who were just like me. That was the beginning of the Imperial Liberation Front. Gideon, Scarlet, and Vulcan were among those I recruited. I'd also met Vita then. I only knew her as the woman who would often come to see Kyan. She guided me to a place below the city of Ordis, and there slept the Azure Knight Ordeen. One after another, I overcame the same trials you did with your friends, but alone. And once I'd proven myself worthy, Ordeen accepted me as his awakener. That was 3 years ago. I was 16. My preparations complete, I concealed my background and enrolled in a military academy near the capital. Everything I did for the sole purpose of taking the Chancellor's head. Come on now, what's with the face? You look sadder about all this than I do. I swear, I'm not trying to tell you the Chancellor was evil or anything. Still, there's no denying that he managed to outwit my grandfather. And he may have lost, but Pops always loved a good gamble. It's thanks to him that I'm pretty good at chess, card games, that kind of stuff. I'd say it's fairly normal for a student to want to avenge his master's defeat, wouldn't you? At the end of the day, there's no denying this country has problems, and the Chancellor's methods were making them worse. I studied those problems, worked out how to use the situation to my advantage, and then won the game with an all-or-nothing gamble. But when you think of how peaceful Jirai is now, I'd say I've got a duty to clear up the mess left behind by my game too, which means ending this war and restoring peace. So it's only when that's done that my game is truly over. I don't want whatever your decision is to be influenced by my past, okay? Like Rufus said, you need to think long and hard about what it is you're fighting for you, more than anyone else. Anyway, I think I've stuck around here for long enough. You're gonna be treated as a visitor. Well, sort of. It's about time for the higher-ups to head back to Heimdall, so go ahead and pass the time however you want. There'll be no guards outside your room, so if you want to try and escape, be my guest. Just keep in mind that some members of Ouroboros and Zephyr are on board too. Not to mention me, Scarlet, and Vulcan. So if you're up for a gamble of your own, get ready to take all of us on. Oh yeah, one more thing. There's this real cute visitor in the guest of honor's room on the second floor. I think she'd perk right up if she saw you. So why not go pay her a visit? Just don't go making your girl jealous, okay?